Welcome to the FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Terror-Born Prince. Chapter 1. The Birth of the Terror-Born Prince. In the kingdom of sorrow, where rain fell as if the sky itself mourned day and night, Queen Elara's tears were no strangers to the people. Her longing for a child filled the castle with a palpable melancholy that even the perpetual storms could not wash away. Many years had passed, with countless remedies tried, and just as many failures endured. It was under these grieving skies that Queen Elara, desperate and forlorn, sought solace in the kingdom's sacred grove, beside the ancient Willow of Whispers. The willow, draped in cascades of silver-green leaves, stood alone in a clearing, its bark gnarled with the weight of centuries. Legend held that the tree possessed the wisdom of the ages and could grant wishes to those pure of heart. Beneath its sprawling canopy, Queen Elara knelt, her sobs merging with the rhythm of the rain. Each tear that fell from her eyes soaked into the earth, mingling with the life-giving waters that nourished the roots of the magical willow. As twilight deepened, cloaking the world in shades of gray, a remarkable transformation took place. A shimmering pool formed where the queen's tears had fallen, its surface smooth and undisturbed by the raindrops. From this luminescent pool, a figure began to emerge. It was Prince Caelan, born not of flesh and blood, but of water and the queen's boundless desire. He rose fully formed, a young man with eyes reflecting the stormy gray of the skies, and hair that cascaded down his shoulders in waves reminiscent of the willow's leaves. Prince Caelan's appearance was met with awe and wonder. The court astrologer, an ancient man with knowledge of celestial destinies, declared that the prince was destined for greatness, that his heart would be as brave as the storms were fierce. With each passing day, Caelan grew not just in stature, but in wisdom and strength. His body maturing at a miraculous pace, set by the magic of his birth. On the 16th day of his life, the skies above the Kingdom of Sorrow cleared for the first time in months. It was a sign, the astrologer proclaimed, that Prince Caelan was ready to embark on his journey to prove his valor and earn his place as the rightful heir to the throne. With the kingdom watching, the young prince, armed with only a sword forged from the mirrored steel of the willow's tears and a shield emblazoned with the crest of sorrow, set out from the castle gates. His destination was the Grotto of Shadows, a place whispered about in the tales told by the fireside. Located deep within the heart of the enchanted forest, the grotto was said to house the whispering echoes, spirits that tested the hearts of all who dared to venture into their domain. The path to the grotto was not marked on any map. It was a path that only those chosen by fate could see. As Caelan journeyed through the forest, the terrain changed with each step. The trees grew taller, their branches twisting into intricate patterns that blocked out most of the sunlight, casting the forest floor into twilight. The air was filled with the scent of ancient pine and the distant sound of a river that seemed to murmur secrets. Wild creatures of the forest watched from the shadows, their eyes reflecting a mix of curiosity and respect for the tear-born prince whose reputation had preceded him, even in the wildest parts of the kingdom. The closer Prince Caelan got to the Grotto of Shadows, the denser the forest became. Thorns as sharp as daggers and vines, as tough as ropes, seemed to guard the way, as if challenging him to prove his worth. But Caelan, driven by the force of his destiny, wielded his sword with precision and grace, clearing a path through the obstacles with an ease that belied his few days of life. By the time he reached the entrance of the grotto, night had fallen, cloaking everything in darkness save for the glow of his sword, which illuminated the cavern entrance like a beacon. Stepping inside, the temperature dropped, and the air grew thick with the power of old magic. Here, in the depths of the Grotto of Shadows, Prince Caelan would face his first great test, a test that would prove his courage and his right to claim the throne of the Kingdom of Sorrow. Thus began the legend of Prince Caelan, the tear-born prince whose journey from the sacred grove to the heart of darkness would be sung about for generations, a testament to the enduring power of hope and the unyielding strength of a queen's love. Chapter 2, The Grotto of Shadows. Deep within the heart of the enchanted forest, cloaked under the canopy of ancient oaks and shrouded in perpetual mist, lay the Grotto of Shadows. This mysterious cavern was the destination of Prince Caelan on the second day of his quest, a place famed across the kingdom for its trial of the Whispering Echoes, ethereal spirits known to test the hearts and minds of those who dared to uncover its depths. As Prince Caelan approached the grotto, the forest seemed to recoil, the air growing chillier with each step. The entrance was a gaping maw in the mountainside, vines draped across like the curtains of a stage, setting the scene for the trial to come. Drawing his sword, which gleamed with an otherworldly light, Caelan stepped into the darkness, his eyes adjusting to the dim light within. Inside, the grotto expanded into a vast network of tunnels and chambers, each echoing the slightest sound into a chorus of whispers. The walls, slick with moisture, reflected his torchlight in eerie dancing patterns. Caelan proceeded cautiously, aware that each step took him deeper into the realm of the echoes. The air was thick with the scent of damp earth and ancient stone. Stalactites and stalagmites formed jagged teeth in the mouth of the cavern, creating natural barriers that he navigated with agile grace. As he ventured further, the faint whispers grew louder, morphing into discernible voices, tales of old battles, lost loves, and whispered secrets of the forest. Caelan reached the heart of the grotto, a vast chamber where natural light somehow filtered through cracks in the ceiling, casting beams like spotlights on the chamber's center. Here, the whispering echoes awaited him, manifesting as shadows on the walls. Their forms were ever-changing, fluid as the water that dripped from the mossy stone above. The first echo approached, its voice a soft hiss that seemed to come from every direction. "Prince of Tears, born of sorrow and hope, answer true. What is the strength of a leader?" it asked, its tone echoing off the walls. Caelan, standing firm in the center of the chamber, replied without hesitation. "The strength of a leader lies not in his might, but in his ability to lift others when they fall, to bear the burdens of many, and to guide with wisdom and compassion. His voice, confident and clear, silenced the whisper for a moment. Satisfied, the shadow shifted, and another echo spoke. Prince born from a queen's desire, what is the value of a kingdom? The question was more philosophical, probing his understanding of rulership. The true value of a kingdom lies in its people, Caelan responded, his sword held loosely at his side as he spoke. Lands and treasures are fleeting, but the spirit of the people endures, shaping the kingdom's legacy. With each correct answer, the light in the chamber grew brighter, the shadows less menacing. Yet, the final echo posed the hardest question of all. What sacrifice would you make for your people? Caelan paused, his heart heavy with the weight of potential futures. After a moment of silent reflection, he answered, I would lay down my own life, for a true leader places the needs of his subjects above his own desires and safety. My life for their peace. At this, a profound silence filled the chamber. The echoes, satisfied with his answers, began to fade, their forms dissolving into the air like mist at dawn. In their place, a pathway lit by the now radiant light led Caelan out of the grotto, signaling his success in overcoming the trial. Emerging from the grotto of shadows, Prince Caelan felt a sense of accomplishment, but also a deeper understanding of his destiny. The trials had honed not only his resolve, but his understanding of what it would take to be a king. One who ruled not from a throne of gold, but from a place of wisdom and sacrifice. The path out of the grotto wound back through the forest, now less menacing with the knowledge that he had faced and overcome the fears that it harbored. As he walked, the flora seemed to bow, and the fauna watched with a newfound respect. Caelan's journey was far from over, but the Grotto of Shadows had prepared him for whatever lay ahead, teaching him that true leadership was born not of power, but of humility and the willingness to serve. With the whispering echoes behind him and the trials ahead, Prince Caelan continued his quest, each step forward, a step closer to his destiny. To prove his courage, earn his throne, and lead his kingdom into a new era of prosperity and peace. The echoes of his trials lingered in his mind, shaping him into a leader fit for the challenges to come. Chapter 3, The Trial of the Elemental Beasts. After emerging victorious from the Grotto of Shadows, Prince Caelan pressed onward to the verdant plains, a vast expanse where nature's unbridled spirit roamed free. Here, the true test of his worth awaited in the form of the elemental beasts, legendary creatures, each embodying the raw essence of a primal element. These creatures were not only guardians of their respective elements, but also holders of the talismans Caelan needed to claim his place as the rightful ruler of his land. His first encounter was with the Serpent of Water, a sleek and shimmering creature that inhabited the depths of Lake Miramir. The lake, known for its crystal clear waters, mirrored the sky above, creating a perfect backdrop for their confrontation. Caelan approached the water's edge, where the serpent awaited, its scales glinting like wet stones under the sunlight. With strategic precision, Caelan engaged the beast, his sword slicing through the air and water alike. The serpent responded with agility, diving and twisting through the clear water, attempting to disorient him. but Caelan, steadfast and focused, matched its movements with grace, eventually subduing the creature and earning the talisman of flow, a gem that pulsed with the power of the tides. No sooner had Caelan secured the talisman than he headed towards the scorched earth of Ashen Mount, where the lion of fire prowled the land. The ground beneath his feet grew warm, then hot, as he neared the heart of the lion's domain. Ash and smoke filled the air, and the smell of sulfur signaled the lion's approach. With flames licking its mane, the lion of fire charged, its eyes burning with a wild, untamable ferocity. The battle that ensued was a dance of flame and steel, with Caelan weaving through the blasts of heat, his shield deflecting the intense flames. The prince used the lion's fiery nature against it, leading the creature through a series of strategic maneuvers that ultimately saw the beast tire and yield, allowing Caelan to claim the talisman of blaze, a stone glowing as fiercely as the fire from which it came. With two talismans in hand, Caelan ascended to the Windy Crest, the highest peak where the Eagle of Air reigned supreme. As he climbed, the wind picked up, howling and whistling around him in a fierce symphony. Atop the crest, the eagle awaited, its wingspan casting a formidable shadow. The battle with the eagle was a test of endurance and skill, as Caelan had to predict the creature's swooping attacks and respond with precision. It was a ballet of gusts and strikes, each move timed with the rhythm of the wind, culminating in Caelan capturing the talisman of breeze, a feather that shimmered with the hues of the heavens. The final challenge led Caelan to the stone forest, where the bull of earth charged through the labyrinthine formations of ancient, petrified wood. The ground shook with each step the bull took, its raw power a formidable force of nature. Here, Caelan's strategy shifted to one of patience and environment, using the stone corridors to his advantage. Dodging, weaving, and leading the bull on a chase that tested both his physical agility and tactical thinking, Caelan finally cornered the creature where the dense rock formations limited its movements. With a calm presence and a gentle touch, he soothed the raging beast, earning the talisman of Terra, a crystal imbued with the essence of the fertile earth. Exhausted yet exhilarated, Prince Caelan gathered the four talismans, each a symbol of his mastery over the elements and a testament to his readiness to lead. As the sun dipped below the horizon, casting long shadows across the verdant plains, he reflected on the trials he had faced. Each beast had challenged not only his physical abilities, but also his understanding of balance, power, and leadership. Now, with the elemental challenges behind him and the talisman secured, Prince Caelan was ready to return to the Kingdom of Sorrow. His heart was full of stories to tell and lessons learned. Each step forward on his journey back to the castle, a step closer to his destiny. The trials of the elemental beasts were more than just a test. They were a rite of passage, transforming the tear-born prince into a sovereign ready to rule not through dominion, but through harmony with the very forces of nature that had once seemed insurmountable. As Caelan left the plains behind, the talismans in his possession glowed faintly, each in sync with the natural forces it represented. The journey back to the kingdom was long, but Prince Caelan walked with the confidence of one who had faced the raw elements of the world and emerged not only unscathed, but emboldened. He was ready for the final trial, the coronation trial, where he would prove not just his right to rule, but his vision for a kingdom united under his leadership. Chapter 4, The Coronation Trial. With the elemental talisman secured, Prince Caelan returned to the Kingdom of Sorrow, his journey culminating in the ancient ritual ground known as the Circle of Thrones. Here, beneath the watchful eyes of the kingdom's elders and assembled populace, he was to undergo the coronation trial, a ceremonial test of leadership that would either crown him as king or reject his claim to the throne. The Circle of Thrones was a hallowed place, set in a clearing surrounded by the oldest trees of the kingdom. At its center stood four majestic thrones, each carved from a different element, and each representing one of the elemental forces: water, fire, air, and earth. The thrones were ancient, their origins lost to time, and they were said to possess the power to truly discern the worthiness of a would-be king. As Caelan approached the circle, the air was thick with anticipation. The crowd fell silent, their eyes fixed on the young prince who had departed as a boy and returned as a leader. In his hands, he carried the talismans: the Gem of Flow, the Stone of Blaze, the Feather of Breeze, and the Crystal of Terra, each a symbol of his victories and his bond with the elemental spirits. Caelan began the ritual by approaching the water throne. With reverence, he placed the Gem of Flow upon the seat, the throne reacting with a soft glow that emanated a cool mist, enveloping him in its embrace. This mist swirled around the circle, touching each onlooker and leaving a sense of peace in its wake. The water spirits whispered their acceptance, their voices a melodic hum that resonated with the flowing waters of the kingdom. Next, he approached the fire throne, placing the Stone of Blaze upon its fiery counterpart. Immediately, the air around the throne heated, and flames danced along the throne's edges in a controlled yet spectacular display. The fire did not burn him. Instead, it warmed him, invigorating his spirit and energizing the crowd. The fire spirits roared in approval, their voices crackling like a great bonfire, signifying strength and renewal. The air throne was his third destination. Here, he laid the Feather of Breeze upon the seat, which caused a gust of wind to sweep across the circle. The wind twisted and turned, weaving through the crowd, lifting spirits and whispering of change and freedom. The air spirits sang a soft, whistling tune, approving of Caelan's lightness in heart and swiftness of mind. Finally, Caelan placed the Crystal of Terra on the Earth Throne. As soon as the crystal touched the stone, the ground itself seemed to breathe a sigh of relief. Flowers bloomed spontaneously around the throne. Grass grew greener, and a sense of stability and fertility spread through the land. The earth spirits murmured their deep, resonant approval, grounding the energy of the ceremony and affirming Caelan's connection to the land and its people. With all four talismans placed, the thrones began to resonate together, their energies intertwining in a dazzling display of light and power that spiraled upwards into the sky. This spectacle was more than just visual. It was a sign, a confirmation that the elements themselves had accepted Caelan as their true sovereign. The elders stepped forward, their faces alight with joy and relief. The lead elder, a wise old woman with eyes as deep as the history they bore, declared, by the power vested in us by the ancient laws and the will of the elements, we crown thee, Caelan, King of Sorrow, protector of the realm, and harmonizer of the elements. A crown made from intertwining branches of the sacred trees, imbued with essences of water, fire, air, and earth, was placed upon Caelan's head. As it touched his brow, the crowd erupted into cheers, their voices blending into a cacophony of celebration. The sky cleared for the first time in days, sunlight bathing the new king and his people in warm, golden light, as if the heavens themselves were blessing his coronation. King Caelan raised his hands, calling for silence. When the crowd settled, he spoke, his voice carrying strength and warmth. "Today, we stand not just as subjects and ruler, but as a united people under the elements that have long guided and protected us. Let us move forward, not in sorrow, but in prosperity and peace, embracing the harmony that has been bestowed upon us this day." His speech was met with another round of cheers, louder and more spirited than before. The ceremony concluded with feasts and festivities, the air filled with music, laughter, and the clinking of glasses. As the stars began to twinkle in the evening sky, the people of the Kingdom of Sorrow danced and celebrated, their hearts lighter than they had been in years, for they knew that their new king was truly the leader they had longed for, a ruler born of tears, but crowned in joy.